for many, many years, people weren't really aware of the consequences of lead in the environment. We had leaded gasoline and we had leaded paint. The biggest problem with this particular bridge was that it had been repainted many times since it was installed in 1913. So the thing we had to do was try and figure out how to get that lead paint off and not let it get introduced into the environment. What we had to do is we call lead abatement, which means that we're going to remove all of that lead-bearing material and get it out of the environment. We're going to take it to a special landfill where they're engineered to deal with these kinds of materials. When the project started, they ran a number of cables across the canyon. They built a temporary aluminum deck, and the workers used that. That's how they got around on the bridge while they did the lead abatement. Once they had the platform constructed, they basically cocooned the entire bridge in plastic so that nothing falling off could fall through and get down into the water. The workers were able to sandblast off the existing lead paint, layers of lead paint. The final step, once we had the bare metal exposed, was to repaint the bridge using modern non-lead based paints. It wouldn't be unreasonable to expect this bridge to continue giving good service for another 100 years.